This is a community-supported legal education channel. Find out how you can support our mission at the links in the description below. So, Blizzard has released Warcraft 3 Reforged, much to the chagrin of many of the enthusiastic players who were very much looking forward to a remastered and reforged edition of Warcraft 3. They even say so on their website here, a complete reimagining of a real-time strategy classic. Experience the epic origin stories, more stunning and evocative than ever before, with reforged visuals, Azeroth born anew, with legendary campaigns, exhilarating gameplay, and limitless custom games. Well, some of that sounds like it's an outright lie, so let's go over it. Warcraft 3 Reforged was just released on January 28th and is supposed to add revamped graphics, improved modding capabilities, an altered campaign, balance changes, and modern BattleNet features, but as you can see, player response has been largely negative. On Metacritic, with 4,400 reviews, the score is 0.9. 0.9 out of 10, indicating overwhelming dislike. And not just that, but there's now a new custom game acceptable use policy that apparently grants ownership of mods and maps directly to Blizzard. We'll go over that in a moment. And there seems to be no easy way to get refunds if you are unsatisfied with the product and believe that it is not what was promised. I personally bowed out of buying any further Activision Blizzard titles after I was dissatisfied with Destiny 2. It seemed to be more of a cash grab than a game. Like, you'd get through the story parts of the campaign, and then there wasn't a whole lot to do after that. Kaylee and I would run around the world and try to find things to do, and it was just basically various enemy spawns that you could shoot up and then go get more loot. Okay, I'll give it that it's a looter shooter, and maybe looter shooters aren't for me. And then there was the time at BlizzCon 2018 where everyone thought they were going to announce some new Diablo something, and instead it turned out to be a Diablo mobile game where they then sort of condescended to the gamers saying, "Don't you guys have phones?" Well, yes, I have a phone, and it's even a pretty good phone, and I'm sure some people don't have the world's best phones for playing games on, but it was heck of a thing for them to assume that everyone wanted a Diablo mobile video game. I hope it worked out for them for their sake, but it didn't work out for the gamers who were anticipating a new Diablo title. And then there was the Blitzchung controversy during the October 2019 Hearthstone Grandmasters Tournament. Blitzchung won his match, or I believe he even won the tournament, and was supposed to receive approximately $4,000 in prize money, but he had the audacity to publicly support the Hong Kong protesters, as you do, and they said he would be banned for tournaments for a year and would lose his prize money. It took the overwhelming response of the player base, as well as a letter from a congressman, I believe it was Marco Rubio, and Ron Wyden, and Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, Mike Gallander, and Tom Malinowski. They sent a letter to the company requesting a full reversal, and Blizzard eventually reduced the punishment, but still maintained that what Blitzchung had done and said was wrong and had no place in video gaming. Yes, freedom. Freedom has no place in video gaming. How about, like, the freedom to game and game together? How about the coming together of the communities and the people and all that? Gosh, it's just so tone deaf. Well, now gamers are upset that the promised Warcraft 3 Reforged improvements don't seem to be improvements at all, but rather just a quick cash grab. Unit movement is locked to 20 frames per second. This is 2020 we're talking about here. We've got monitors that go 240 frames per second. I'm playing at 60 frames per second here because I'm on a laptop, but still, 20 frames per second is unacceptable. The cutscenes are exactly the same, even though they promised improvements, and you remember what they said here, it would be a vivid reimagining, more stunning and evocative than ever before. no new campaigns, even though I believe they said that there was going to be changes to the campaign. No new interface, bad translations into other languages, no custom game lobbies, no reworked story elements, charging money for different models, different character models, I guess. They took out automated tournaments, clans profiles, and the competitive ladder. And they took out 3D animated campaign backgrounds and 3D animated portraits, the communal chat listing, custom campaigns. And then they also claim ownership of your custom maps. That's a real interesting one, considering what happened with Dota. If you're not familiar, I had to kind of look this up myself. Back in 2002, when Warcraft 3 was released, the mod support was either pretty good or modders were good at modding the game without support. I couldn't tell you which one it was. But there was a world editor, and someone created a world called Reign of Chaos, and that eventually became a mode, a gameplay mode called Defenders of the Ancients. That developer or developers who made that, a couple of them, Ice Frog, I think, was one of them, were eventually hired by Valve to recreate their mod as a standalone game, which I believe became Dota 2. Ice Frog was hired by Valve, and yes, to lead the sequel, Dota 2. So it was, the first Valve version was Dota 2. And that was universally seen as a stupid move on Blizzard's part to let such a franchise get away from them. So their answer this time seems to be to just claim ownership of your mods and custom games. And I thought maybe this would be a good place to go over things from a legal perspective, since I'm a copyright attorney and not playing any Blizzard video games anymore. So if you want to know more about the controversy, go search for it and things. We're going to go over the legal ramifications of this. In their custom game acceptable use policy, which is part of the Blizzard end user license agreement, they say that they own your custom games, which shall remain the sole and exclusive property of Blizzard. Without limiting the foregoing, you hereby assign to Blizzard all of your rights, title, and interest to all custom games, including but not limited to any copyrights in the content of the custom games. If for any reason you are prevented or restricted from assigning any rights in the custom games to Blizzard. Now, I read this, if for any reason you are prevented or restricted, might even mean that you personally just want to prevent them from owning your copyrights. Then they say that you at least grant Blizzard an exclusive license, a perpetual license, a worldwide license, an unconditional license, a royalty-free, an irrevocable license enabling Blizzard to fully exploit the custom games for any purpose in any manner whatsoever. That's an extremely broad grant of copyrights, and it basically has the same effect as if they own your copyrights. They hold the license exclusively. You can't give it to anybody else. They hold it forever, for all places worldwide. So maybe the moon or Mars would be the next place that they might not have a license. It is an unconditional license. There's no conditions. There's nothing you can place, no conditions you can place on it. It's royalty free. They don't owe you anything, and it's irrevocable. So if you make a custom game for Warcraft 3 Reforged, you lose all of your copyrights or rights to the map. You further agree that you will execute future assignments or related documents so they can enforce you having to make further agreements with regards to those maps. To the extent that you are prohibited from transferring your moral rights, because those are things that are applicable in some countries, then you waive your moral rights as much as possible. Blizzard even removes the right to remove your custom games and require that a custom game developer cease any development or distribution of a custom game, and your Blizzard account can be subject to disciplinary action if you do not comply. So you'd better comply, or else you could lose your Blizzard account and the value of the titles you have on it. So your entire account, if you violate this policy, can just be gone. They say that custom games may not develop custom games that include a mechanism to limit access. You can't use third-party content. So even if you somehow made a fair use of third-party content, I'm not sure what that would look like, but let's say that you were able to do that somehow, you represent and warrant that the content you create and incorporate will not infringe any copyright, trademark, patent, trade secret, or any other intellectual property of a third party. Of course, they also have something in here about the user content not being unlawful, tortious, defamatory, obscene, invasive of privacy, threatening, harassing, abusive, hateful, or racist, and otherwise objectionable or inappropriate. In the event that Blizzard learns of the existence of a third-party claim, Blizzard reserves the right to remove it. Yeah. Unless otherwise authorized, custom game developers cannot develop games for profit, so you're not allowed to make it for profit, but they do say that you're allowed to get donations, so that's weird. No profit, but you can donate to a custom game developer under these terms. Donors shall not be provided with any in-game special advantages, such as private access, special levels, graphical markers, special text, abilities, units. So you can't have any recognition whatsoever in your custom games. Corporations, limited liability companies, partnerships cannot be listed in the credits. Only individuals may be listed. So maybe the donor individuals can be listed in the credits. They have a policy on the use of Blizzard's trademarks and copyrighted content, which must be used in accordance with these guidelines. And Blizzard reserves the right to demand that a developer cease any requests for funding and remove the request for funding from the donation site, and the developer of the custom game agrees to promptly comply. So you basically give up all of your freaking rights to anything that you make for this game. And then they even make sure that it's difficult for you to get a refund. You can inquire about a full refund, but if you purchased it at retail, you're subject to the retailer's return policy. But then when you go down here a little further, you acknowledge that Blizzard is not required to refund amounts you pay to Blizzard for use of the platform or for digital purchases made through the platform for any reason. And then there are some additional things down here. If you have a Blizzard balance, that's not refundable. Beta tests and purchases are not refundable. Residents of Australia might have some kind of right under the Australian Consumer Protection Act over here. I found this very difficult to read. This Consumer and Competition Act of 2010 doesn't seem to clearly say when people get refunds or not. But it does say that misleading or deceptive conduct could lead to some kind of claim for damages, and maybe this falls under that. I do see that the EU has a 14-day opt-out portion, but that doesn't necessarily apply. The 14-day cooling-off period does not apply to all purchases. Sealed audio video computer software which you have unsealed, and online digital content if you have already started downloading or streaming and agreed that you would lose your right of withdrawal by starting the performance. So you might not even have a right to refund in the EU. Still, a user SensatorLS on Reddit has instructed people to go to this link on battle.net and request a refund, which won't show up for the product, but if you paste your order ID in the form from the transactions page, then you might be able to request a refund. Of course, you could also try refunding through your purchase medium, like your credit card or something like that. Be careful of that. If you do that, you might find that your entire Blizzard account gets blocked. Kind of like if you buy something on Steam and then reverse a purchase on your credit card on Steam, Steam might lock your entire Steam account. Same thing with Blizzard. They might see the chargeback as some sort of attempt at fraud and simply block your entire account. So you could end up losing your entire Blizzard account if you do that. Now, maybe that's something that you want to do anyway. Me, I think the best thing to do was just not to purchase games from Blizzard or Activision Blizzard anymore. They seem, just like Bethesda, they seem to be squeezing as much cash out of their corporation as much as possible. It seems like there's no more consumer friendliness in either of those companies. The heart of gaming is sort of lost because they are so greedy and just want to release what appears to be a minimal re-release to get a maximum amount of money, which sometimes is why we call them heartless and soulless corporations, because they have lost sight of the shareholder value they could be creating by making a long-term investment in their gaming community. Instead, they seem to be doing the best they can to squeeze money from the stone, you know, squeeze blood from the stone. You're only hurting yourself when you do that. So let us know about your experience, and if you have any further suggestions about how to handle this in the comments below. So that's our show, probably the last one for January of 2020. Please, if you can, support our channel for the month of February by going to patreon.com/LJFrench and sponsus.com/law. This is a community-supported legal education channel, and we would not exist if it were not for your financial support. Thank you very much to our $50-plus supporters for the month of January: Aspernari, John Steele, Gavin Barnard, Kyle Mudrock, Michael Pierce, Jan DeGray, Spirit Bear, Daniel Perez, Snorre Wizotsky, Blackleaf, Joe Tyson, Evie, Benjamin Hightov, Steven, Cute Grills in Your Area, and Ada. And thank you to the $5-plus supporters who are scrolling on the screen in front of me. I will see you in February. Love you all. I'm Leonard French, your favorite copyright attorney. Have a good one. Bye.